Hi, I'm Stephen Foster. We're here today to talk a little bit about what's going on at the Tobias Lear House. I'm here with John Schnitzler, who is the project manager on the project. John Schnitzler's, you know, he's something I've never understood about him. He's 55 years old, but he says he's been working for Strawberry Bank for 40 years. So I wondered if maybe you could explain that to me, John.
It's very easy. I started when I was 8 years old.
That's what I thought.
Yeah. No, I'm actually 63, and I've been there 42 years.
So the math
is 21.
Started at 21.
Yeah, 21.
And just tell us a little bit about what you've done over the 42 years.
2 years. Well, basically, I've been restoring old houses my whole life. Growing up in this neighborhood, this area, I acknowledged the old house, the old houses that were here, and I learned to like them and enjoy them. Also, as a kid, I could go around all the forts and all the abandoned houses, so that's what sparked all my interest in this.
Are you a native of Portsmouth? Or?
I am a native of Kittery, which is just across the river.
Isn't that in Maine?
Maine. When I was a kid, I had my boat, and I was a pirate, and I went up and down this river many times.
No kidding.
Did all kinds of adventures that way, yeah.
So you remember what this neighborhood was like?
Oh, yeah, yeah. We didn't come to this neighborhood. Yeah, it was a place to stay away from. It was a little rough, but a wealth of 18th century houses,
yeah,
is what I really wanted to be involved with. So I pursued a job at the museum and liked it and stayed there.
And you're hands-on.
Yeah,
carpentry.
I'm a restoration carpenter for,
yeah,
sure. Carpenter,
but
yes.
You do everything else.
But yeah. I do a lot.
Yeah. I wanted to kind of explore a little bit with John what the idea we had of the house, the issues with the house before we got in, just kind of set the stage for that.
Yeah, well, when you started getting involved here, you were lucky that the group that owned it before you had a few people come and give you reports on the historic nature of this building.
Yeah.
And that was helpful. So that gave us a good start as to what it was you were buying. We knew it was 18th century, but we didn't realize all the little flukes and changes and other things that have occurred here. So we've been reading the house and trying to...
Yeah. Sometime in the 1730s, this started off as a 2-over-2 house with a gable roof. And we think sometime in the 1760s, it was expanded, doubled in size, and put on this astonishingly big roof.
Hip roof,
yep. Yeah. When they went from a 1730 house to expand it, the configuration in the 1730 house changed. And so that's one issue that we wrestled with before.
Yeah, struggle with.
And we're still working on it, right?
Yes. Yes, but there is no going back to that time frame, of course. We are 1760s and beyond.
And then some other things happened down the road. The house was occupied by the same family, the Lear family, until about, I think it's about 1850. Then it became a kind of a multi-family tenement house, I guess you could call it, a boarding house, for 50 or 60 years. And then there was a restoration effort that took place in the 1920s that did some work on the house, quote unquote, restored it, and that's raised some issues.
They're very clever trying to do this colonial restoration period, and some things are obviously been changed, we can tell that, but then some things are kind of a little more difficult to really decipher.
Right.
Introduction, I think, of new materials.
When we were looking at the house before we got in, every time we looked at something that seemed a little, I don't know, not quite right, Was it a natural change that just occurred over time, or was it one a change that happened during this 1920s restoration when someone stuck a piece of paneling or something else in there and was basically trying to disguise it as I guess you could say. So that's sort of the setting when John finally got into the house, what, a month or two ago?
Yes, started.
And yeah, 2 months. So what we think we'll do is just take you room by room and kind of look at some of the things that that John discovered and that some of the things we're still scratching our head about.